Man, today we are in Alabama, running the Outcast. That's right, everyone. So today I'm actually here to fly, meeting with our good friend Jeff in Lower Alabama. If you don't tune in for the flying adventures, go ahead, check them out. Maybe this is another hobby that, or part of the hobby that you might want to get into. I find it quite fun and interesting. Definitely challenging. Those that think that squeezing that is a lot of control when you're manipulating two joysticks to work all the surfaces. Flying is something else. But yeah, I'm waiting for him. We're gonna do some flying. I figure in the meantime, maybe I'll do a little ground pounding and flying of the Outcast. Look, it's gonna make a mess, but you know what? It does look cool with the water streaming off. And I don't think I've taken this up that ramp. Oh wow, look at So I'm actually thinking about doing a whole week of bringing out the old cars, because we've just been focused so much on all the new stuff. That haven't really had time to play with the old cars. Definitely need more speed to hit this ramp with something this heavy. The cool thing with this KC ramp is that normally, you know, the smaller cars you can hit with very little speed, man, and they fly. Oh, wow. The Outcast. Man, I have not had this thing out in a minute. Oh, this is going to be a messy, messy thing to clean up. See, now, guys, I just did that wheelie, and I know the damn sun's right there. It's going to be bad. I did that wheelie about half throttle. You know, you can use about full throttle to get it up on a wheelie. But once you get there, try to throttle back. This is how people end up ungluing and blowing their tires off, or one of the reasons. See, I can just, let's see. And this is wet grass. See? Not sure how well that showed up, but. See, I'm about like, and I'll stay off the runway. I don't wanna. Oh man, this thing is a blast. The only thing I don't like with the 8S is like how heavy they are. They do weigh a lot, man. It just hurts my back to even mess with these things. But oh, it is something else to watch, something this big. Oh, that was freaking cool. I was debating whether this is a Creighton for coming out here, but I figure it's taller grass. Maybe I'll use this one. More ground clearance. Yeah, man, so much new stuff has come out. Look, about half throttle. There's no need to just stand on the thing and blow the tires off. You know, it's weird. Yeah, I like doing wheelies. I like doing this stuff. And people said, oh, the Creighton won't do it. The Creighton won't wheelie and all that stuff. But, man, dude, my Creighton wheelies like anything. I don't. Look at how cool that looks. It's going to be messy cleaning this up. But, man, it looks cool. The water spray. That's the nice thing with the 8S. Man, they can just, like I said, just. They can just roll through the stuff where, like, you know, your little 10 scales, they don't have the weight. And when you hit these things, you know, out here like this at speed, they tend to like bounce and roll, where the fifth scales here aren't as bothered. Oh man, that's gotta be like the longest wheelie ever. This is loving the wet grass. Man, I need to get up close for that stuff. That's gonna be like an awesome thumbnail or something. Man, this is a beautiful place for running something like this. It's a really good place. Maybe right here through this stuff, it'll see if we can get a good thumbnail. These things are so heavy, man. They're scary when they're coming at you. Yeah, I don't think I would have this much fun with the smaller scale RC and this much land. I mean, I imagine I would, but it's just not gonna drive like these big. That's what, every RC is different. All the different scales are different. I mean, like the 10 scale right there at that speed probably would just been like launched in the air and would have tumbled. These things are just such massive shocks and suspension. Oh. Oh. Woo. Like that, man. It just. But the weight of it saved it. Oh. Oh man, guys, I do wish I was kind of like in some dirt or something like that where I could slide a little bit more, because I don't want to come out here and shred up this grass and then have like the groundskeepers hating and then they start banning RC stuff. So you gotta be respectful when you're out using these like city parks and stuff. Don't want to come out here and start any troubles. It's kind of like, you know, you walk your dog, clean up the poop. You know, you don't want to start problems for other people who want to bring their dogs out and have fun. Don't come out here with the RCs and shred the grass and annoy people. Like if somebody was walking with their dog right now, I would stop because the dog might try to chase this thing. Oh my God, look at all the wet grass. Oh man. Oh boy. This is gonna be a dirty girl clean up, man. This is so much fun. I still enjoy flying. I enjoy everything, man. RC, I just got that new boat. That thing is so much fun. Ah, oh, man, guys. The Outcast. What do you think of it? Is there one that you're thinking of? Like, do you have one? The Outcast versus the Creighton. What's your thoughts on the two? Because I have both of them. And I mean, even though this is a shorter wheelbase, I mean, it wheelies easier, but the Creighton still wheelies. And this thing does pretty good right here. Going fast to the... Let me know which one's your favorite. Creighton versus Outcast. Or are you you the X-Max person? Because I have them all. I like them all. I would say I think the X-Max is probably a bit more durable. It's taken an absolute beating, and I have not yet to bend like an axle shaft or break a control arm. I did break a control arm for that. I really don't blame that. I mean, I was in a skate park and the thing landed from like 15 feet in the air on that back tire. Yeah, that thing's like 40 pounds. That's a lot of weight to stop and put on just one suspension part. It really is. But just even normal jumping, you know, it does tend to bend the axles a bit. I would only say that my biggest complaint, or I would say like dislike this versus the X-Max's weight. This thing is just really, 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 really heavy. It just is. I need to get better at like coming at the ramp and hitting it. I'm no good at standing here and... Woo, shit. Well, like I said, see, that's what I'm no good at. I'd rather be behind the RC. But I gotta practice this. There we go. Woo! It's kind of scary, man. I'm telling you, standing here, having something that damn big come at you. That's another key thing too. You know, you're in the air. You hear me like, I'll blip the throttle because, you know, it's nosing down. But you hear it's not on throttle. I don't even care if it lands bad, like, once it's on the ground. But I try my best not to land with power on, because that's how you shock the drivetrain and bust the gears. I think I hit that sideways. Woo! All right, one last one. I think we're gonna wrap this up, because All right, let's check. Something sounds weird. Something sounds weird. Oh, that front axle's way, way, way bent. See, every time. See it? It's hitting the shock. Every time, man. I know. And then somebody will make a comment about, oh, land better. You know, screw you. If you're that person that's got nothing more intelligent to say than land better, screw you. I mean, just honestly, that's just a dumb comment. Nobody can land perfect 100% of the time. The vehicle should be designed to withstand a certain amount of bad landings in that. So, you know, I swear, and I think the people that make those comments, one, don't even have an RC car, and two, they just like to start shit. It's unfortunate, but yeah, screw you, man. I don't want to hear it. You know, there's a reason that it's like EXB, extreme bash. That's why they put these heavy duty stuff so it can withstand like hard landings. I mean, even if I make a bad landing from that height, it shouldn't be as hard as a good landing from 15, 20 feet up. So it should withstand. Like I said, to me, the Achilles heel on this are the axles. I think maybe they're just a little too long. And when it lands, it's either the axle just bending due to the size of it and it stays bent, or something with the control arm maybe is flexing and it just bends it. But it's like that's why I don't really like jumping these things anymore. Not these. Oh well, it is what it is, man. I still love the truck. It looks freaking amazing. It's fast, it's powerful. I have a good time with it. So man, I hope you enjoyed watching the Owlcast come out here, get all grassy and dirty for you. Hope you enjoyed watching that. Guys, please check out the links down below. Help me pay for new parts for this thing. If you use Amazon, use my store. If you're buying cars through A-Main or Horizon, use my affiliate links. These things really help me bring you this content. All right. Appreciate it. Thanks for watching. See you on next one.